Hello everyone, my name is Samriti Singla and I'm going to present the paper, The Raptogen Operator for Processing Big Raster Plus Vectorator. Today, various research applications use machine learning to analyze and utilize spatial data. This data often comes from various sources and in different data representations. This makes it necessary to pre-process this data in order to combine it into a single data representation that can then be used by the algorithm. However, it's a computationally expensive process to combine different data representations into a single data representation. This is because spatial data can be represented as either raster data or vector data. Raster data refers to the remote sensing data or the image data. It is represented as a multidimensional array of pixels where each pixel represents a value, such as vegetation. On the other hand, vector data represents points, lines, and polygons. A few examples of vector data include GPS points, roads, and regional boundaries, and it is stored as a collection of coordinates. A few applications that use raster and vector data include crop yield mapping, yield interpolation, and wildfire modeling. The application of crop yield mapping performs in-field and across-field analysis. To do so, it requires to combine agricultural fields available in vector format with surface reflectance values available in raster format. The application of yield interpolation estimates a function in target regions based on values in source regions. The source and target regions are available in the vector format and are combined by using a reference dataset available as a raster. The application of wildfire modeling uses data to build machine learning models that can be used to model the spread of wildfire. It combines fire occurrence data available in vector format with rasters representing geographical factors. Since the representations of raster and vector data are so different, these applications need to convert them to either representation before combining them. This conversion process is computationally expensive and hence a bottleneck. Moving forward, I will talk about existing systems and why is combining raster and vector data computationally expensive. The difference in the representation of raster and vector data make it difficult to combine them. This is also the reason why existing systems focus on either raster data or vector data. A few examples of raster-based systems include GeoTrellis, SciDB, RASDMAN, and Google Earth Engine, while vector-based systems include Spatial Hadoop, Apache Sedona, and Simba. In this slide, we show how the existing approaches work. The vector-based approach takes as input the raster data and the vector data, but it vectorizes the raster data before a vector join can be performed on the original vector data and the vectorized data. Similarly, the raster-based approach takes as input the raster data and the vector data, but it needs to rasterize the vector data before performing a raster-raster join on the original raster and the rasterized layer. The conversion of data from one form to another is computationally expensive and leads to a huge increase in the size of data. This makes these approaches non-scalable for high-resolution data. However, the proposed approach, Raptor, takes as input the raster data and the vector data and performs the proposed Raptor join on them. The proposed approach does not need to convert data from one form to another, but can work with data sets in their native formats. It is hundreds of times faster than existing approaches and is flexible enough to support various applications. Next, let's talk about the proposed raptor join approach. First of all, let's see where we can use the raptor join operator. Our first application is yield interpolation. We first take as input the vector data and then the raster data. Please note that these datasets are hosted on HDFS and do not need to run any additional ingestion process. Next, we perform the raptogen operation on the two datasets, and the output of the raptogen operation can be used in combination with other operators. For example, in this application, we compute histograms of the output based on the geometry ID and the pixel value. Next, for the application of crop yield mapping, we first take as input the vector data, which is then filtered since we're interested in the California region only. Raptogen is an operator that can be combined with other operations either before or after it. After that, we take as input the raster data that has various raster files that range over 5 years. Next, we perform the raster join operation on the raster and vector data. The output can then be processed as needed. The last application is of wildfire modeling, where we input a raster data set, a vector data set, and then perform the raster join operation on that. The output is used here to compute statistics for each geometry. Please note that we can compute both algebraic and holistic functions here, for example, mean, median, and mode. The code for Raptor Join is open source and available at the link given on this slide. It is integrated into Beast and can also be accessed from the QR code on the top left of the slide. We faced a few challenges while building the Raptor Join operator. The first challenge was how to help users avoid the cost of pre-processing. Unlike some existing raster-based systems that need to load and structure data before processing, we use an in-situ approach where data can be read as is. The second challenge was how to scale with high-resolution raster and large vector data. To answer this, we created the Flash Index, a compact on-the-fly index that can be used to speed up the mapping between raster and vector data. The third challenge was how to support all geospatial data types. To solve this, we've implemented three predicates for each data type and according to application needs. The last challenge was how to adapt one single operator to a dog applications. To tackle this, we chose a relational data model, which makes it easier to combine with other operations, as you saw in the previous slides. Raptor Join is a distributed join operator, which takes as input a vector data set V, a raster data set R, and a predicate theta. It outputs a set of geometry pixel pairs that satisfy the predicate theta. To be able to work with all geospatial data types, we define three predicates, one each of points, lines, and polygons. We show an example of these predicates in this slide. For more detail about these predicates, you can refer to the paper. Raptor Join is modeled analogous to a sort merge join algorithm, while raster-based systems resemble a hash join and vector-based systems resemble an index-nested loop join. To resemble a sort merge join algorithm, Raptor Join exploits the inherent structure of raster and vector data and requires to read each dataset at most once. It does so by building a compact on-the-fly index structure termed Flash Index. It runs in three steps: creation, optimization, and processing. In this slide, we show an overview of the whole process. The first step is the Flash Index creation. It takes as input the vector data set and the raster metadata. The raster metadata represents the size and coordinate reference system of the raster and is only a few kilobytes in size. It partitions the vector data across machines and computes the Flash Index for each partition based on the predicate. Flash Index represents the pixel ranges that overlap with geometries. The colored squares in this figure represent the pixel ranges. You can find more detail about the Flash Index is computed in the paper. The overhead of the Flash Index is up to 0.1% of the data size. The second step is Flash Index optimization. Now, why do we need to optimize the Flash Index? We need to do this because pixel ranges for each partition may belong to the same tile. Each raster is divided into several tiles that can be randomly accessed. If we process them as is, the same tile will be read multiple times leading to suboptimal performance. Therefore, it is important to reorganize the pixel ranges in such a way that all ranges belong to the same tile lying in the same partition. We also reorganize pixel ranges to take advantage of the way data is read into the cache memory. The last step is Flash Index processing. It takes as input the sorted pixel ranges and reads the corresponding values from the disk. The order of the input ensures minimum disk access and memory requirement. The output of this step is a stream of geometry and pixel pairs, which can then be used as input to another operator. In this case, they're directly processed and will never be kept in memory. Next, I will talk about the experiments we conducted. We ran an extensive experimental evaluation on a cluster of one head node and 12 worker nodes, where each worker node had 64 gigabytes of RAM and 2x6 word processors. In each experiment, we computed the four aggregate values, minimum, maximum, sum, and count. We compared the proposed system to three raster-based systems, Google Earth Engine, Rasterman, and GeoTrellis, three vector-based systems, AdapterCell Tri, Sedona, and Beast, and one raster plus vector-based system, Raptor Zero Statistics. These are datasets that we used. We use vector datasets that represent points, lines, and polygons that cover either the US or the world. These datasets have billions of points and hundreds of millions of line segments. We use raster datasets varying from a resolution of 1 kilometer to 3 meter, whose coverage varies from California to the world. The first experiment that we conduct is with vector-based systems. Since the baseline adapter cell try is limited to a single machine, we compare it to the single machine version of Raptor Join for the 300 meter resolution dataset MERIS. As can be seen, Raptor Join is 10 to hundreds of times faster than ACT and is also hundreds times smaller than ACT in index size. ACT does not scale for high resolution loss datasets. The experiment between distributed vector join implemented by Beast and Sedona against Raptor Join also shows that these systems are hundreds of times slower than Raptor Join and do not scale for high resolution datasets. The experiment between single machine Raptor Join and RasDemand for small resolution datasets showed that Raptor Join is up to hundreds of times faster. We use single machine version of RasDemand as it is publicly available, but the distributed version is not. We also observe from these experiments that RasDemand does not scale for big vector data. Next, we perform an experiment with distributed raster-based systems. From these, we observe that Raptor Join is two orders of magnitude faster than the baselines of the Earth Engine, GeoTrellis, and Raptor Zonal Statistics. We also conduct experiments for points and lines for Raptor Join and Google Earth Engine. As can be observed from the bar charts, Raptor Join is up to hundreds of times faster than Google Earth Engine. At last, we run an experiment for the applications we discussed earlier against Google Earth Engine and find Raptor Join to be hundreds of times faster. To conclude, we propose a new raster vector join algorithm called Raptor Join that has many advantages. It is an in situ approach that can combine raster and vector data in their native formats. It is modeled as a relational join operator with three predicates to support all geospatial data types. It uses a novel index structure, Flash Index, which makes it scalable as evidenced by the experiments run against the various baselines. In future, we plan on extending the system for machine learning algorithms and answering the approximate queries. Thank you.